Flav City family, what is up? Today's Flav City short is all about hummus and dip, a very popular request lately, and this is part of our January New Year series. I want you to shop for and put the best quality products and ingredients in your body. We're doing 6 to 7 videos a week in January, which is why you have to like, subscribe, share, but more importantly, there's a bell icon right below the video. Make sure you enable all notifications, because with 7 videos going every week, you want to get a push notification. All right, when it comes to hummus, it's really interesting. So here's a brand called Cedars, right? And I always look what kind of oil they use here. So check it out. Chickpea is great, sesame seed, tahini good, but we have sunflower oil. So that's problem number one, because if you're an astute Flav City fan, you know sunflower oil is just as bad as corn oil, veggie oil, canola oil, soybean oil, because it's highly processed and highly refined. You want to see expeller pressed if you see something like sunflower oil. The thing is, I'd much rather see extra virgin olive oil. Raise your hand if you normally see that in the ingredient list. They don't have it here, so for that reason, I'd say no. But luckily here at Whole Foods, they do have some better options. So I come around here, and we have the motherland, the holy land of hummus. And this, in my research, is one of the best hummus I've found. And there truly is hope these days, because Hope Hummus is making hummus with extra virgin olive oil and no filler. So that's what you want to see. It's a little pricey. It's $4 for an 8-ounce container, but that's what you want to see. Whereas we saw sunflower oil before, you don't want to see that. But look what I spy out of the corner of my eye. It's organic Cedars hummus. So we look at the ingredients and they change a little bit. We see they do have organic extra virgin olive oil, but before that, they have organic sunflower oil. So great oil, still a crappy oil, because even though it's organic, it has to be expeller pressed. So it has to say organic expeller pressed sunflower oil. So it's not there. They do the same thing with Sabra brand, that's soybean oil. But riddle me this, Art and I are trying to figure this out. This is hummus with an O, and this is hummus with a U. Can you please leave a comment down below? We don't know what the difference is. I almost feel like the O with the underscore is more Middle Eastern or something, but we need your help on that one. Now, moving away from hummus, we look at dips. You guys, Siete dairy-free vegan dips are amazing. This is the cashew queso. Holy schmoly. The flavor on this is amazing. Look at the ingredients. All best in class. It's cashew-based with vegetables, fermented foods. This honestly tastes just like nacho sauce. They have a sprouted bean dip. They have a white cashew dip. One of the best Bobby approved vegan grain-free options, especially for the tortilla chips ever. Here's a local one. I'm not sure if they have it outside of Chicago. It's called Field and Farmer Curry Turmeric and Lentil Hummus. And we look at the ingredients. Look at that. Extra virgin olive oil, real ingredients, simple, all thriller, no filler. Looks like they're a local Chicago mom and daughter dynamic duo. So that's really cool. We like to support them. A lot of people get excited about bitchin' sauce. I get excited. When I see a name called bitchin' sauce, I want to get it. And it looks like it's plant-based, but we put on our little monocle here and we look at the ingredients. Everything's good, right? Almonds, nutritional yeast, Bragg's, liquid aminos. But guys, grapeseed oil? Grapeseed oil is just like sunflower. Unless it's expeller pressed, you don't want it. Actually, it's a really interesting story. Years ago, the wine industry came up with grapeseed oil because they had all these leftover seeds from the winemaking process. They're like, what can we do with them? Make oil. But unless it's expeller pressed, it's garbage, in my opinion. Listen, why are people using extra virgin olive oil? Why aren't they using avocado oil? I know it's cheaper. I know, hey, it must be the money. But if I have a product in 2020 called Flav City XYZ, if I don't put avocado oil on there, if I don't put best-in-class ingredients in there, you have my permission to punch me in the face, all right? Art knew I was gonna say that. What else here? Let's go over here, because there's a couple other dairy-free dips here. And by the way, when you see tahini in hummus, it's this. It's fine ground roasted sesame seed paste. It's the Middle Eastern version of peanut butter, and I love that stuff. But let's close this Flav City short right here. Here's a dairy-free ranch dip from Kite Hill. And I normally love this company. I've never seen a bad product from these guys. This is ranch, dairy-free. But this is the first time I've seen something that I can't approve. It has maltodextrin from corn. It has natural flavors, and it has yeast extract, which is another word for MSG, so I wouldn't get that, right? But there are really good options. If you know of other hummuses that use extra virgin olive oil that we didn't have here, leave a comment down below. It's all about the devil in the details, which is true for everything in the grocery store. So I hope you enjoyed this Flav City short. Tons of info for you to make the best quality choices in the new year. Two more of those videos are going below us right now. But Art and I will see you very soon. Until then, hashtag keep on cooking. Mad love and peace.